Hey, I am Jelle, and last week I joined the legendary Braggy's Game Jam. With over 10,000 people joining and only 7 days time, I knew I had to make something special to stand out. So I did what I did best and started writing down a bunch of ideas. I was writing so hard I dropped my pen. It was at that exact moment I knew what I was going to make my game about. Let's make a game about fingers working together. Alright, I knew I had a great idea and plenty of time, so I'll start soon. I have plenty of time. Yeah, so it's Friday evening and I haven't done anything yet. And the game has to be done by Sunday at noon. Not that I'm worried, of course. I'm expert at last minute extreme speed game making. I started writing down a plan of attack, listing all the things I wanted to do. I went right into the main attraction, the 3D hands model. First I was going to make like an actual hand, but then I would have to rig it up and spend all this time weight painting. And I don't have time for that. So, a robot hand, it is. This also means I can just parent different parts to each other, so I don't even have to rig it up. What a time saver. Okay, so I've got this cool hand model, but what is the game going to be about? Well, let me explain. The robots have taken over the world, but there are all these human technologies left, and it's your task to learn how to control these ancient technologies. Like, for instance, these buttons. You do this by moving each finger separately and then hitting a button to get some points. Imagine it's like the Turing test. But be careful, you only want to use the correct fingers to push a button, because you never know what might happen if you press the wrong button. Also, I promise it will be easier to lift your ring finger in the game than in real life, because I can't get mine up for the life of me. I mean, body, please. As the sun went down, I knew I had to lock the controls this night. I only have 2 days, remember? So I got to work and added the fingers into Unity. Gave each segment a collider and a rigid body, so I can apply some physics to it. Well, now it's just a floppy finger. No one is going to hit anything with that. But luckily, I can use the trusty configurable joints to help me here. I set up the target rotations to 0. And now the finger tries its very best to stay up right. The next step was making it controllable. I was planning to use a key on a keyboard for every finger. And since there is just pressed and not pressed on the keyboard, I made 2 finger states, a straight one and the curled up one. Then I added all the other fingers and connected them to the hands. You would start out all your fingers curled up, and then when you press the correct key, the finger would straighten out. Finally, I added a way to push the hand forward, to go push stuff. All you have to do is press space and push. Your hand goes forward. Time for the first demo. Yes, great, great, wonderful. Who needs VR when you can just have this? It's much better. I can get the hang of this in no time. Alright, that was a productive evening. The hand controls are done, and I'll see you tomorrow, hand. Sleep tight. Day 2. Let's go. The first thing I made were the buttons to, you know, press. Pretty important. I added a push trigger and lined them up, one for each finger. I left the thumbs out because I quickly realized it's impossible to press the thumb keys and the spacebar at the same time. Also, there's a limit to how many keys you can press at the same time, apparently. Who would have known that? I added a scoring system where you get 5 seconds to push a button, and you get more points per push the faster you are. And when you're too late, you would lose a whopping 500 points. It's feeling pretty good right now. I've gotten so good at the game that it actually has become a little bit too simple for me. And also, you can just stay forward and press the button like that, so I need to fix that. Perfect! Let's add a lever you need to pull. So instead of just clicking, now you can go forward with your fingers, let go above the levers and go back. And ta-da! You've pulled a lever. But of course, this only works if you have both fingers in place. Because, you know, stronger together. And with that, the inputs were also done. Looking at my list, there was still a lot to do, so I couldn't hesitate. Everything was working, but the background looked kinda boring. I went into Blender, destroyed the default cube, added another one, and started shaping the control panel. I tried all kinds of things, but the panels kept looking too busy. I wanted something cool, but not something that would distract the players. In the end, I went with something like this. Nice and simple. A little gradient texture, a couple of buttons, and a clear score display. I ran the game again and noticed a giant game-breaking problem. You have to go forward with your fingers to grab a lever, but that also meant you would also have to push both buttons above. So that would always detract 1000 points. Did this mean I had to totally rework my entire system with less than 24 hours to go? No, of course not. My giant master brain came up with the perfect idea. Right now, you get points from pulling levers, just like the buttons. But what if I added a little retractable part behind the buttons that would randomly retract? Then you would have to use the levers to pull them back. Amazing. This brings the game to a whole new level of awesomeness. I played this version for so long. It felt like forever. Well, that's a problem actually. There is no way to lose right now. You can get negative points, but that's about it. I added a life system, represented by these bright bulbs. Every time you press a wrong button or wait too long, you would lose a life. Well, it suddenly became a lot harder. Perfect. All this pressing and pulling was pretty fun, but I needed some tunes and sound effects to spice things up. I got my iPad and started jamming, making something that resembles a fun tune with some autoplay loops and some tuckling on the keyboards. Easy win. For the sound effects, I went to my library and found the perfect sounds. Well, after a little bit of tweaking, of course. And now the game sounds like this. It was already so late in the evening, well, technically it was Sunday already, so I went to bed, leaving the last to-dos and the finishing touches for Sunday morning. As the sun rose up and looked at the beautiful sunrise, I realized that my game really needed a lighting makeover. I added an HDRI, a high dynamic range image, all around, and some lights. Together with some color correction, the game looked much better. I made a start screen and I drew a control scheme image in basically 30 seconds. Wow, such art. I threw it in and built the game, took some screenshots, made an epic cover image in Blender and submitted the game right on time. That is the end of our checklist. Woohoo! Now, let's take a look at what it has become. Alright guys, you know what time it is. It's time to play the game. My finger dexterity is extremely high. There is no challenge that I can't overcome. Using my fingers as magic weapons to pull the levers, press the buttons, and get the points. I haven't even lost a single life. It's like I'm perfect at this game. I'm pulling some real finger gymnastics here. Up, down, up, far, back, forward. The points are just racking up. Oh no, the first error has come. And it's over. Whew. Thanks for watching, everyone. Be sure to like and subscribe if you liked what you saw here and want to see more of this in the future. You can play the game right now on itch.io through the link below. Some people say it's pretty hard, and I have basically one thing to say to them. Get good. And I'll see you guys next time, where I've really got to clean up the mess I made. Bye!